way we mug up on stamps.
I tout for arty business.
And sharpen those pencils for some seriously square art.
Hello!
And welcome to Smart. Ooh, you're looking good, Mr. Spate. In the pink, I'd say.
Ooh. Oh, thank you very much. I must say, that shade of lipstick really suits you.
Thank you. Should we reveal the joke?
I think we should. Yes.
We draw on faces on our chins.
Yep, just get a makeup pencil, draw a pair of eyes, a nose, and a generous amount of lipstick, and let your mouth do the talking.
And then all you need to do is pop a headscarf over the top half of your face and hair, and you can have a right good chin wag.
Yeah, talking of which, should we get on with the show?
Yeah, we've got some more spooky and kooky faces to show you over here.
Right, here you go.
Time to go on that. Cheers. Get this off, eh? Look at these fearsome fellas. They're actually made from shriveled up apples.
Yeah, you know when you get that rotten apple left in the bowl? Well, don't throw it away because you can turn it into a piece of art. There's one for you, Kirst.
Thank you very much. First thing we need to do is get rid of the skin, so we're going to just peel that off. Keeping fingers well clear.
Oh, look at that. It's coming off nicely.
OK, I'm set. Are you?
Yeah, beautiful.
Next thing you need to do is decide on your design. I think I'm going to do a spooky owl.
Oh, yeah. I think I'll do a freaky face.
OK, I'm going to just sort of sketch my design on. Bit of a heart shape for the owl.
Oh, no. I've got to make mine look ugly.
Got a mirror. Now we're going to use plastic knives to just cut away the bits we don't want in our design. I'm just going to cut in here.
OK, here we go. Right, let's bore his eyes out first.
Ooh, I've got to be careful that I don't cut that nose out. Oh, it's nearly going. Wait! I've flicked my owl on the floor.
Oh, that's his cheeks.
There we go, look. Now, remember, your design is going to shrink and shrivel up, so it's not going to look exactly how you do it now. Happy with that. Although, what I'm going to do is, using this peeler, the end of it, I'm going to sort of gouge some eyes out, look, in a circle like that. Scoop big chunks out for eyes. Whoa.
Hey, you know what you could do, Kirst, actually? We've got some raisins here and some seeds. You maybe could put raisins in for some rotten teeth some seeds for eyes.
Let's have it. It'll go with some seeds. Make sure you use stuff that isn't going to rot, because that'll stay inside your apple and you don't want it to go off in there. There we go, a couple of seeds for eyes. I think I'm happy with that little fella there, look.
Oh, he looks great. Hang on, let me put his teeth in there.
Now, it takes about 4 weeks for them to shrivel right up. You could help the process by popping them in the airing cupboard. And to do that, we need the end of a paintbrush, I think.
We do indeed, there you go. There's one for you.
Thank you very much. Or you could use a pencil or a bit of garden cane and just push in, keeping your fingers well clear. So you've got something to stick them on. And then just leave them to shrivel up. Should I put that in there?
Oh, cool.
There we go. And hopefully they'll end up looking like those guys there. Hey, you know you like sculpting and you love doodling, but no matter how long in the tooth you are, there is always room to improve your smart art skills.
Oh, that's why you packed me off to see Rick Machin. What do you mean long in the tooth?
Well, I hope I've got all I need for my caricature training. Apparently, there's a practical session at the end of the day. That makes me a little bit nervous. Hello, Rick.
Hello, Mark.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks for coming.
Just the man. Now, I've been told that you can help me with my doodles.
Sure, let's give it a go.
But I've also been told to bring in a newspaper picture, which I have, and a balloon, which I'm not sure why, and a caricature of some type, which I have made a start on. But I'm not entirely happy with it.
I actually drew these characters myself earlier on.
Oh, wow, that's great.
The same characters you did, but if you notice, I did it on the newsprint.
Yes.
And the good thing about that is you don't need to carry a sketch pad around with you.
Oh, clever.
Now, the other good thing is that you've always got your reference next to you. So as you're drawing, you can see how you're getting on.
Actually, I was just thinking, looking at that, maybe you could draw directly onto the picture itself.
That would be a good idea.
And just have a go at distorting the features.
Sure. Should we give it a go?
Yeah. Okay. Rick, you start.
Now, I'm going to have a go at Billy. Now, as you notice, she's got this wide jaw, so I'm going to make that jaw even wider. She's also got quite a big mouth, so let's make that even bigger, shall we? Take it right out to there. She has quite a small nose. So what I'm going to do is make her nose smaller. So I've made her mouth bigger, but her nose smaller.
Oh, I see.
So it's not always making big things big. Sometimes you can make small things small.
Right, I see. So how do you decide how to shape the face?
Ah, that's where the balloon comes in handy.
Right. Okay.
If you squeeze this little guy, can you see now?
Oh, I see, can you see?
So now, everything's been squeezed up to the top part. But if I lower it down, now look what happens. Now everything's down here.
So you just apply this to your artwork?
That's right. So I look at the face and decide where am I going to take from and add to.
Bearing that in mind, I'm ready to have a go at the doctor. So what would you say my prominent features are?
Well, you've got quite a strong jawline, so I'm trying to pick that up.
Now, Kirsten always said I've got a very broad... Well, she said I've got a big head. Would you agree?
I think maybe in proportion, yeah. It's slightly larger than the rest of the
Thanks,
face.
Rick. Now, how do you make that Anne Robinson caricature look so lifelike?
Well, I take the pencil sketch originally and scan it in, and then with a computer program, I can zoom right in very, very close, work on those tiny, tiny details, and then when you drop it back down again, it looks crystal clear.
So why aren't you using white paper?
Reason is that you've got your middle tones already on the page, and then you can add your shadows with your black pencil, and when you want highlights, you use a white on top of the grey. Well, Mark? That's our first draft finished.
Oh, let's have a look. Oh, that's amazing! Actually, I've got a photo of Kirsten that you can do later, but right now, I've got to go off my practical session, to excuse me. Actually, what is a practical session?
Ah, that's where we're going to go out in the street and draw real people.
Oh. How am I feeling? Oh. Excited. Nervous. Can I interest you in a caricature?
Certainly.
Oh, lovely. I'm Mark, by the way.
I'll send you on the box.
Oh, nice one, yeah. We've just...
Arse attack, is it? Look at Ian's face. It's slightly long, and he's got quite a square jaw.
Very nice.
And he's got some great dimples as well.
Are you ready? So, there you go. Nice cheesy grin.
You've really got the shape of the face there. It's nice.
There you go.
I want you to get off my butt.
Who's next? Okay, so here we go. Right.
Eyes fairly close together.
Okay, quite close. Okay. Right, okay.
But she's got a nice big smile.
Yes. Sorry, looking like Terminator at the moment. Yeah. What on earth am I doing?
Those girls are quite big. I
love that. Voila!
No, I think that's pretty cool.
He's got quite a prominent chin too, so we'll make that a little ball.
Right, yeah.
Back up to here.
It's not bad. You can sign it for my son, I'll be happy with that.
Yeah? All right, lovely.
Goodbye. Maybe put a little laugh line on the side of her mouth there.
Right here.
Lovely. Very nice, yeah.
If I was to sell this masterpiece, how much would you pay for it?
£2 to £3.
Should she go higher or lower?
Higher!
Thank you, thank you. Well, that's us done for the day. Rick, not only have I learnt something, but it's also been a real giggle. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Nice to meet you, Mark. And here's a little souvenir.
Bless you. Wasn't that great? In fact, Rick's done a couple of caricatures for us, which I haven't seen yet.
Haven't you?
No.
Let's have a look at them.
Are you ready? I think, yes, that's you. Look at that. Isn't that brilliant?
That is incredible.
Absolutely amazing.
Look at my hair, it's spot on.
Right, let's look at this. Oh, man, that is spot on.
It's actually got your glasses as well.
Yeah, the trademark.
I am lost for words, which, as you know, is very unusual for me.
Which I can thank, actually.
Thank you very much, Rick.
Yeah, they're brilliant.
Thank you very much to all the smart viewers that have been sending in their pictures. We've managed to fit as many as we can in our giant gallery frames here.
Yep, there's a bit of a theme going on in our exhibition of faces. They're all shapes and sizes.
Starting with Alice and Leela's crazy caricature collage.
Rabia Begum from London's done this gorgeous etching. I like the different shades of blue that scratch through, look. Mark Matthew Adele from Sherburn's done a portrait of you.
Oh, I'm very flattered. Thank you very much.
Captured your likeness.
Yes. Now, this is very impressive. Liam from Darlington has done this wonderful chalky Picasso.
Mark, the next picture is amazing. Look,
oh, yes.
It's like a multicoloured maze face from Lucy Murphy in Essex.
That's wonderful. Actually, Emily Bevan from Cardiff has done this really lovely portrait. The thing I like about this is the cheeky grin and the very shifty eyes. We've still more faces over here, Kirst. Look, Sophie Thompson has done this wonderful portrait. I love the way she's parted the hair and this very dreamy look on her face. Isn't that lovely?
I love the fact that Morgan Twiston Davis's portrait looks so moody, doesn't it? Look at those disgruntled lips.
Nice.
If we've just talked about your work in our gallery, you'll be getting a smart sketchbook and watercolour pencil set.
Yes, if you want to see your artwork in the gallery, then send it to us at this address. Smart, P.O. Box 5053, London W12 6AW. Sorry we can't return any of your artwork, but keep it coming in because we love looking at it.
And when we get all of your posts, we peel off the stamps and never once to miss a trick. We use them for artwork.
Yep, like this portrait we've done of me.
And we're about to start one of me. The first thing you need is a picture of yourself, preferably in profile, because that's exactly how the Queen is on her stamps. And then you just need to enlarge that.
Yeah, we've done that already. Look, nice. Now all we've got to do is to fill it in.
I'm going to start with these lovely second-class stamps here. Just start sticking those on.
Yep. While you're doing that, Kirst, I'll crack on with the hair. And I've cut this first-class stamp into strips, you see. All I have to do now is just to layer it so it gives the hair some texture. If I just start down on this strip here and just slightly overlap it, and then what I've got also to enhance your lovely locks
mm-hmm.
is some orange stamps for your highlights.
Ah, thanks for that.
Very luscious. I think I'll just do the eyebrow at the top here, actually. Nice.
Green. No. Oh, hang on. Ah, look at that.
So look.
It's a little turquoise.
Oh, lovely.
47 pence.
Like that.
That's how much my eyes were. Let's get that on there. Lovely. Not only do we use the stamps, we use your envelopes as well, particularly the brown ones that you've sent in. What I've done is I've cut them into little chunks, and this is now the perfect colour for my face.
Lovely flesh tones there. Mm. Actually, I think what I'll do is put some detail around the eyes and, using a dark grey stamp, just go along the line of the eyelids just to pick them out a little bit.
Mm, nice.
Maybe we could do the same with the ear and also under the chin.
Hmm.
I'm getting very stuck now.
I know, that's the trickiest bit, really, isn't it? Trying not to stick yourself to the picture. My ear. It's really starting to come together now, isn't it? Let's have a look. Last chunk here, Mark.
Okay, just finish off the ear. Lovely.
You know what this needs now?
A smart frame.
Mm-hmm. Here we go.
Oh.
Position it nicely. There you go, with a special perforated edge, exactly like a stamp.
You know what, Kirst? I'd say that is first class.
Oh, philately will get you everywhere.
Oh.
What do you think?
I think it's nice as it is. Listen, I'll go for a walk. You coming?
Yeah, just give us a minute.
Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the slowest of them all?
Look, this is an important decision.
Hang on. I've just thought of something that might help you. Follow me. Come on, Snow White. Oh.
So, what's this smart idea then?
Well, I thought we'd draw pictures of ourselves and then swap the features around.
So, are these photos of us part of the plan?
Yeah, they are indeed. Now, if you'll notice, they're similar size photos. That's very important. But you'll be able to see what you look like with short hair.
Okay, what do I have to do?
Okay, first of all, fold your photo flat and then take a piece of cellophane. Now, I got this from some flowers I gave you. Do you remember?
No.
I don't know why I bother. Anyway, here's a piece for you.
Thanks.
Okay, place it over the photograph. Now, what we've got to do now is to draw around the features. But don't draw over the hair.
What's your favourite feature about yourself?
Mine? I think the back of my head. What's yours?
My lips. Finished.
Oh, it's pretty ugly to me. Let's see if my hair improves you.
Thanks.
Trust me.
Forehead now. Look at that.
Oh, beautiful.
You know what they need now? Some colour. We could make them a bit pop arty, couldn't we?
Good idea. In fact, we could use those magazine strips. Excuse me. And give it a little bit of background. Tell you what, we look even uglier than normal.
You speak for yourself. But the magazines have worked really well, haven't they, to bring out the colour in our faces. But one thing's for sure, I'm definitely not going to get my hair cut short. It just doesn't suit me. Where have you gone?
I think I might grow mine. Kirst, what do you think?
Mark!
Just kidding.
I've got an interesting technique to show you now for doing a black and white toned portrait. The first thing you need is a black and white picture, maybe from a magazine or a newspaper. I've got rock legend Jimi Hendrix here. And then what you need to do is put your picture up against a window or, if you're lucky enough to have one, a light box. As long as there's light coming through, it makes you able to see where the light bits are and where the darker, more shaded areas are. You can see the hair's very dark up there. Then all I've got is a piece of graph paper, and I'm just going to sit that on, and then using a pencil, just go around the outline. This is why if you put it up at a window, it's very good because you can trace over and see exactly where you're going. Once you've drawn around the whole outline, like I've done here, it's ready to start doing my favourite thing, which is colouring in. And what I've got are three different thicknesses of pen. You could do this with pencils, but what I'm going to start with is the thickest one, and I'm going to do the darkest areas. So Jimmy's hair is the darkest area. And all I'm going to do is start colouring in. Have the patience.
Next! Ah, now you're looking a bit green. What seems to be the problem?
My ears are too big.
Oh, I think they're fine.
Not my ears, my pictures.
Sorry. Yes, you're right. They are a little large, aren't they? Well, here's a tip for you. All you've got to remember is, when you're drawing a face, is to draw the head egg-shaped. The eyes are three quarters of the way up the head. The nose, bottom of the nose, is halfway across the face, and the mouth is halfway between the nose and the chin. Let's get the nose in first of all. There's your eyes. Now, your ears are exactly the same length as your nose, so if you grab your ear, slide it round, you'll see it's exactly the same length. Good tip, that. Just put the ears in. And there you have the perfect tip for the perfect face.
Thanks, Doctor.
No problem. Next!
Come on, guys! Do your sit-ups, please!
One!
And two! Keep up with me!
Everybody! Everybody! Let's get into it! Get stoned! Get started! Come on! Get it started!
Solution, transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible, and that's how we move it.
Yo, everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it. Yeah. Get stoked, get started, come on. Get started.
Bit of clowning about.
Oh, yes.
Speaking of which, what's all this?
Oh, well, you see, seeing you drawing those tiny squares on the graph paper got me thinking.
Ah, so you've been jotting your thoughts down, have you?
No, these square post-it notes are the idea. Come on, I'll show you. Look, they look like feathers.
Oh, yeah, they do a bit, don't they? They curl up. Can you come here a second?
What?
Thanks. Nice.
Nice.
Is my leg going to be in your way?
Yes.
Is it now?
Yes.
Oh, thanks.
Pleasure.
Give me five.
Hey.
Five.
Excellent.
Ah, clock face.
Yes.
Oh, but that reminds me, that's all we've got time for, I'm afraid.
Yes, don't forget to join us next time for more arty ideas.
Bye.
Bye. Right.
I tell you what, you're going to be a while doing that, aren't you?
Oh, sorry, you're filming now. Oh, sorry.
It's only half done, you chump.